नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जीवन डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ चालाक्य तंत्र, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ बिजनेस यूनिवर्सिटी। आज का हमारा टॉपिक है डिप्थीरिया। डिप्थीरिया इज एन एक्यूट बैक्टीरियल इन्फेक्शन कॉज बाय कॉर्निबैक्टीरियम डिप्थीरिया। इट इज अ ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैसिलस। दिस बैसिलस सीक्रेट्स अ पोटेंट एक्सोटॉक्सिन, अ मेजर डिटरमिनेंट ऑफ द पैथोजेनिसिटी। द चिल्ड्रन आर मोर अफेक्टेड। It occurs mostly in winter and autumn seasons, and both sexes are equally affected. Then the pathogenesis of diphtheria, it spreads through droplet infection during coughing, sneezing and talking, and some persons are carriers of this disease. Once affected, remains infected till the virulent bacilli are present in lesions, usually 2 to 4 weeks. Diphtheria is a rapidly spreading acute febrile illness with both local and systemic pathology. The primary lesion in upper respiratory tract then there occur the necrosis of epithelium, then injury leads to plasma leak, fibrin network formation of bacteria, then pseudomembrane formation, then adherent to the underlying tissue like nose, pharynx, larynx, tonsils, then scraping leading to bleeding. At this site, they produce toxins that is absorbed and disseminate to whole body. Exotoxin affects the heart, kidney, liver, spleen, muscle, peripheral nerves, adrenals. The clinical features: the incubation period is 2 to 6 days, onset with fever, malaise, sore throat, headache, weakness, nasal diphtheria, the serosanguinous discharge in tonsillar diphtheria, the dysphagia, sore throat, cervical lymph node enlargement, laryngeal diphtheria, there is cough, hoarseness of voice, inspiratory stridor, dyspnea. Then respiratory distress, retraction, cyanosis, wheezing, nasal regurgitation of fluids. Faecal diphtheria, there is a grayish white pseudomembrane forms over the tonsils and spreads to the soft palate and posterior pharyngeal wall. It is quite tenacious and causes bleeding when removed. Cervical lymph nodes, particularly the jugulodigastric, become enlarged and tender, sometimes presenting a bull-like appearance. Patient is ill and toxemic, but fever seldom rises above 38 degrees Celsius. Here you can see the image of the faecal diphtheria. Here is an image of the enlarged glands and faecal diphtheria. The complications are the CVS typically occurs after 1 to 2 weeks of illness, like myocarditis, cardiac arrhythmia, CHF. The neurological complications are palatal palsy in second week, the nasal regurgitation of fluid, nasal intonation of voice, ocular palsy in third week that causes a deviation of eye, then loss of accommodation, the blurring of vision, generalized polyneuritis in 3 to 6 weeks, and paralysis of diaphragm. Diagnosis made by the clinical feature with detection of pseudomembrane, Albert staining of swab from oropharynx, larynx. But culture takes 8 to 10 hours to be positive, and don't wait for the culture report to start the treatment. Management in any suspected diphtheria, immediately start treatment with antitoxin and antibiotics. Antitoxin is a mainstay of the treatment to neutralize the free circulating toxin in the blood that is not bound to tissue. Antibiotics are used to eradicate the organism producing the endotoxin and to prevent the spread. The antitoxin dose is based on the site involved and the duration and severity of disease. 20,000 to 40,000 units for diphtheria in less than 48 hours or when the membrane is confined to the tonsils only. 80,000 to 120,000 units if disease has lasted more longer than 48 hours or the membrane is more extensive. Antitoxin is given by IV infusion in saline for 60 minutes. The antibiotics used are benzyl penicillin 600 mg 6 hourly for 7 days. Erythromycin is used in penicillin sensitive individuals 500 mg 6 hours orally. And then the next diphtheria is laryngeal diphtheria. It is secondary to faecal diphtheria, affecting children below 10 years of age. Incidence of diphtheria in general is declining due to widespread use of immunization. Then pathology and the effects of laryngeal diphtheria is due to formation of tough pseudomembrane over the larynx and trachea, which may completely obstruct the airway. Then exotoxin liberated by the bacteria leading to myocarditis and various neurological complications. The clinical features are general symptoms, the onset with low-grade fever, sore throat, malaise, but patient is very toxemic with tachycardia and thready pulse. Next clinical feature is laryngeal symptoms like hoarse voice, whoopee cough, inspiratory stridor, increasing dyspnea with marked upper airway obstruction. Next clinical feature is membrane, grayish-white membrane on tonsils, pharynx and soft palate. It is adherent and its removal leaves a bleeding surface. Similar membrane is seen over larynx and trachea. Cervical lymphadenopathy, the characteristic bull neck may be seen. Diagnosis is always clinical but confirmed by smear and culture of Cornebacterium diphtheria. Treatment is started on clinical suspicion. Treatment is the diphtheria antitoxin, 20,000 to 40,000 units IV route as saline infusion after test dose. We should go for antibacterials like benzyl penicillin or erythromycin if allergic to penicillin. Then maintenance of airway like tracheostomy, direct laryngoscopy, removal of membrane and intubation. Then complete blood rest for 2 to 4 weeks. The complications of diphtheria are asphyxia and death due to airway obstruction, toxic myocarditis and circulatory failure, palatal paralysis with nasal regurgitation, laryngeal and pharyngeal paralysis. For prevention, we should go for isolation of patients till 2 cultures from nose to throat are negative. The care of contacts keep under observation for at least 7 days. No role of prophylactic antitoxin is there. Then we should go for active immunization, replace TT with TD. Thank you so much. This session is powered by digital version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you so much.